understand when you meet him. Be nice. He's a little nervous. I guess anything else I would say would get me in trouble later. So, ladies and gentlemen, Tadao, from a lawsuit.
Watching the American anime, and I watch anime, and I listen to
And soon
if I ever got to the game, you know, I would be out, and I'd wake up 2 hours later, there's a reverse Gucci label on my forehead. How many of you realize the theory of the nuclear reverse from your mother? And I'd wake up and be like, oh, Tadao, you look so funny. You said the how you all doing dainty, and your mother's plus, your mother, all properly plus, dainty, you said what? All shoes, with Tadao on the table, over here, and whack, right into the piece of the forehead. Yeah, I know. Mom, so yeah, anyway, so I was telling him, I said, who's going today? I'm sorry, the Northerners. Sorry, I don't know. Northerners don't have a funny accent. So I changed it up, and I told him I was from East Glasgow, Scotland. Very funny, but very, very funny Glasgow, Scotland. But no one ever believed it. What am I going to do when I killed the bagpipe? Yes, I played bagpipes. So, there's lots of weird things that happen. Okay, you're all actually proud, you're all understanding. Who's the reliable one in your group? Raise your hand. Who's always being called on the left and right? Hi. Nice to meet all my fellow rescuers. Just as soon as you know, I am the rescue guy. Why? Because I'm the actor. I'm Japanese. Anyway, so my favorite phone calls, to remind you, if anyone has any similar phone calls, I mean, I have these phone calls, like the top five, six, first, the bottom one is the leader. So now, I told you you're stuck in a skin swallow. You guys don't have this. No, it's really funny. A friend of mine calls, and she is stuck. I don't know how she wants to call, you know, it's like, why don't you call your husband? He's in the fire department. Like, no, I don't want it going out of the call. Okay, fine. And you're like, I have to go and I have to break down the door. Marco, oh, she's upstairs, you're upstairs. And, you know, the door's locked. The bathroom door's locked. So I have to bust down the door.
Uh-oh.
And there she is, so stuck in the closet this way. She's blonde. And pardon me, yeah, she has no clothes on. I don't know why. She was able to reach the cordless one, which was covered here, and the tip was cut. But she couldn't reach the towels. You know what it is to be a Japanese guy to break it on the bathroom and find a blonde? Standard anime? You get me on the open line, and so we got to put out. I never figured out why she got to put stuff in there. Her husband called me years later, saying, why did the tone get stuck? I don't know, you're married. My other favorite phone call is, now, help, I'm stuck in a snow drift. Right? And I get a call for this. I'm like, okay, where are you? Because I'm living in sunny California. I'm in Washington State or D.C. D.C.? I'm in sunny California. Well, you're calling, and you don't understand. The AAA doesn't work on this. Okay, fine. Now, the worst thing, she does work for the Department of Defense. And she gets stuck out there. So I finally make a few million phone calls, and the guys are off the East Coast. Will you please meet her and find a reasonable phone call that's like triple A to get her out? And my friends are calling left and right. Finally, what it takes is a friend of mine gets a favor from a guy named Antonio. You know, Antonio, he's an Italian, but he owns a pickup truck. A tow truck, you know? And he's in New York. They both get into the car. They've been assured that my young friend, who has got like 12 mochaccinos in the car, all his services, which works with the Department of Defense, and basically she comes and they go racing down. They do it in 3 hours from there to Washington. I swear the thing should have been Andretti. They're calling about how crazy it is. They have to rescue all their friends, and they say, oh my God, I can't believe I'm doing a Tadao rescue. And all of a sudden, Antonio goes, wait, you know Tadao? My other thing is, Tadao, I can't get into the car. A friend of mine in Florida, of all places, I can't get into the car. You don't understand. It's crazy. And by the time, oh, wait, never mind. The highway patrol's here. Oh, okay, fine. I get a call from the Florida Highway Patrol.
This is Mr. Tamamasui. Hey, yeah, who's it? This is Officer Flatten from the Florida. What do I have to do to rescue you guys? Oh, you're there? No, I'm just kidding. Basically, they said, yeah, your friend was a little trouble here in the... Yeah, why is that like a New Yorker flight?
Anyway, basically, she says that, you know, she couldn't get the car. She has this nice Land Rover. okay? It's got the little remote thing, and she gets into the car with the remote, and she couldn't get it because the remote, the remote won't work. I said, well, you probably just need to change the batteries. 7-Eleven down the street can get you batteries. But I can't get in the car, I can't get in the store because, okay. If I can get you in the car and get you started in the car, will you go? Because I can, but you can't get in the car because she's always been told, I just told you, I have to turn the button to make the venture. Okay, fine. Picks up the whole set of keys and the big keychain and then takes out the key. It's the door. And opens the door. She's been told she only needs to use the remote control to open the door and start the car. Sorry to say, she really is a blonde. oh, and my favorite one so far is Help Tadao, the house is on fire. Did you call 911? No, I decided to call you first. Call 911. I will be there 20 minutes. Here's the funny part. I won't say whose name it is, but it is Pharaoh. It's not you. It was a fairly famous comic book author, writer, and creator. Who called me telling me his house is on fire, I mean their house is on fire. And I'm like, okay, fine. And I'm like, what do I want? Get out, get the kids. Where's the car for? We're going to go, get out of the house. I think they expected me to come in on a line, wearing a cape. I missed my opportunity to be a superhero, but hey, what about that? Let's see, which leads into the other point, is I get the other last phone call, which is, kitchen on fire! Okay, fire extinguisher near the door, by the refrigerator, all the deal got it! Click. I've never been to their house in New York at all. I'm revealing nothing because they're my friends on Facebook, and if you're my Facebook friends, you might actually be able to figure this one out. My family, just, I do have a long line of family in Japan, and I really want to say thank you to everyone who's been also supportive of Anime Detour, and I thank you all very much about this. But, sometimes I worry about this. Oh, I should tell you, 90% of the family's all fine. They're all crazy. And I missed a couple of cute phone calls, but the relay from my parents is basically all my nieces, nephews, and cousins. Calling, but Uncle Tadao was so horrible. There was all this shaking going on. The worst part is after 20 hours, we ran out of power on the PSP to the Game Boy. We had to talk to the family. This was quickly followed by my parents relating exactly what their parents were saying. Tadao, this is your fault for being a bit of humor. You are a beast of a normal sort. Fine. You panic, right? You're gonna go, what are you doing? You're the rest of the family thinks I'm crazy. Basically, it's like I said, that was the kid. I'm the only guy in the family who got to eat sushi. My uncle owns a restaurant. Why am I feeling I'm a stereotypical Japanese guy? I owned a restaurant back in California, Sacramento. It's in the state capital. No, it was before the governor was there. Oh, this is where we get to know our governor to beat up your governor, except in a WWE match. But anyway! So basically, they're going on, and sushi is a big deal in California. So if you're raw fish, hey, they bought the raw fish, want to try some hot wine? So there's this thing where they make lots of lunches, because everyone comes in before we actually open the store. So everyone's in the kitchen, and we're all chopping away at sushi, and then we put in the dish, someone comes in, takes the dish, changes out of the empty dish, brings it over to the sushi guy, my uncle, they make the sushi, and they go bento box, and they go out. And this takes a while before we have to open the restaurant. So there's this thing about cut flip into the dish, and da 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 da. I'm an actor. Waking up anything before 3 o'clock in the afternoon is I've had friends call me at like 10 o'clock in the morning, basically going, are you still awake? Yes, I am. No, I'm cutting the sushi, and it all goes in. And one of the guys said, now my kids got to go to the dentist, I got to go to the doctor, can we switch? I've got this small spot near the door. I go, okay, fine, whatever. I said, no, go to the waiter at his place. And I'm cutting, and we're kind of going, I said, going on about 10, 15 minutes, or whatever. What's going on? I don't know, I smell something, I smell smoke, what's going on? I don't know, and they were cut, and then I was kind of going, now I go, what? I realize I've been cutting a whole tuna for the last 10 minutes, and there's nothing in the dish. I hit the dish, and I hit the hot teriyaki grill over here, and I burned a whole half tuna. I convinced my uncle to take black and tasty sushi. My hand is not fine. Now here's the funny part, is like 2 weeks later that he goes, did follow-up appointment. Now, this time, the entire restaurant crew and my family figured out what's best to do. They put me in the middle of the room with that big chopping block you always see in television. They put me there. There's no way anything could happen. So, like, when you're listening and you're thinking it kind of is not, and, you know, when we fill up a whole dish, you know, a long dish, short dish, someone comes and sings it out and gives you another plate, but we're all in this rhythm, so they just kind of switch it up real quick. It's kind of like, you know, magic. And, but they have to hot wash a lot of the dishes, and they just switch it out sometimes they're wet. And the problem is, when you're listening to a chopping of 12 people or 15 people making sushi, it's kind of like listening to the pachinko game. It's like,
Hey,
that way. Now, I'll run it back.